to one and all. I am very happy to introduce myself. I am Professor D.R. Bindu N. Arkasali, Associate Professor, working in the Department of Commerce and Management, Maharani's Women's Commerce and Management College, Mysore. Friends, we are living in the midst of COVID-19, that is coronavirus disease, the greatest threat to human beings and also humanity. We have to face this greatest Herculean challenge very successfully, and we have to contribute in our own way to face this greatest threat. Okay friends, now it is the time to discuss something about overheads in the cost accounting subject. Overheads, it includes the topics, the contents, the introduction, meaning and nature, types of overheads, accounting of overheads, which includes collection of overheads, classification of overheads, recording of overheads, allocation of overheads, apportionment of overheads, reapportionment of overheads, and absorption of overhead. And after that, we have to study the primary distribution and secondary distribution, and then we have to conclude the topic. As you know already, here it is written overheads part 1, means after this video, part 2 video follows. Please, you can watch this video and that video, and I sincerely request you to subscribe my channel. Friends, as you know already, cost sheet includes both prime cost and overheads. Prime cost is the sum total of direct material, direct labor, and direct expenses, which is the most important part of cost sheet. And over and above prime cost, there are many costs which we have to consider in cost accounting and in cost sheet. That is overheads. Overheads means it is the sum total of indirect material, indirect labor, indirect expenses. That is aggregate of indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect expenses. In other words, overheads are the cost over and above prime cost. Of course, prime costs are prime in their nature, and there are subsidiary costs. These subsidiary costs over and above prime costs are called as overheads. Therefore, overheads are just operating expenses which support prime costs, prime activities of the organization, which constitute part of total cost. Here, overheads are also called as just a burden on costs, and also they are indirect costs. Friends, there are different types of overheads based on the functions, based on their nature. There are different types of overheads. Overheads are based on functions, may be classified into four categories, four types of overheads. That is production overheads, or manufacturing overheads, and office overheads or administrative overheads, selling and distribution overheads are the basis of these functions. Production function, administrative function, selling function and distribution function, this is one classification. On another ground, overheads may be classified as fixed overheads, variable overheads, and semi-fixed or semi-variable overheads. Friends, as you know, overheads relating to production activities, that is manufacturing activities, they are called as production overheads, and overheads relating to office and administrative work, they are called as administrative or office overheads, and overheads relating to selling activity and distribution activity, they are called as a selling and distribution overheads. Fixed overheads are fixed in their nature, and they are constant up to a certain stage, up to a certain level of activity, and therefore they are fixed in their nature. They are called as fixed overheads. Variable overheads are those overheads, they vary according to the level of production activity, according to level of output they vary, and therefore they are called as variable overheads. And the combination of fixed nature and variability nature, there are some overheads which are called as semi-fixed or semi-variable overheads. Okay, we can just move towards next aspect, accounting of overheads. Of course, accounting of overheads certainly has four stages: the collection stage, that is collection of overhead; distribution stage, that is distribution of overheads; redistribution stage or reapportionment stage; and then the last stage, absorption stage. However, all these stages just to be grouped under seven categories: collection of overheads, classification of overheads, recording of overheads, allocation of overheads, apportionments of overheads, and reapportionment of overheads, lastly absorption of overhead. These seven steps constitute the accounting of overheads. Okay, let me allow to explain one by one. The first one, collection of overheads. Of course, we have to collect so many overheads from different sources, from stores records, from financial accounts, from cash book, from wage abstracts, and from other sources we have to gather the different types of overheads. And after that, these collected overheads are to be suitably grouped under common features, and that is known as the classification of overheads. And simultaneously, we have to record these classified overheads, that is recording of overheads. And after that, we have to allocate the overheads. Allocation means it is a process of charging the entire amount of overhead to a particular cost center, particularly to a particular department, because there are some specific costs. These specific costs related to a specific cost center or specific department. Therefore, the entire amount, the full amount, is to be charged to that particular department only. Therefore, allocation refers to a process of charging the entire amount of overhead to a particular department, particular cost center. And however, there are some common costs. Those common costs, they are not traced to only one department. they are common to many departments, means they are common to two or more than two departments. For example, rent of the building, power and electricity of the building, water charges of the building, general manager's salary. These expenses, these costs, they are just common, and common costs are to be suitably divided and distributed among various departments, maybe production departments or different service departments. Irrespective of these departments, these common overheads, common costs are to be suitably divided and distributed among various departments. Therefore, the process of dividing and distributing common overheads between or among various departments is known as apportionment of overheads. Friends, please do remember a reapportionment. Under the process of apportionment of overhead, overheads are to be divided and distributed to many departments. However, the costs or overheads of service departments, they are to be just redistributed to only production department, because service departments, they render service to the production department, they are subsidiary to the production departments, and the costs of service departments are to be recoverable. Therefore, whatever costs incurred to service departments are to be just redistributed to production departments on some suitable basis. And this process of redistribution, the overheads of service departments, the cost of service departments to production departments is known as reapportionment of overheads. Dear friends, and after reapportionment, the next accounting process, so far as overhead accounting is concerned, the absorption of overhead. Once the reapportionment work concludes, then it is the responsibility of the cost accountant to absorb those costs which are reapportioned to production departments to the various products or the jobs, etc., on some suitable basis. Therefore, absorption of overhead is a process of recovery of overheads on some suitable basis, maybe on the basis of direct material, on the basis of direct labor, on the basis of prime cost ratio, on the basis of direct labor ratio, that is labor hour rate, machine hour rate, etc., etc. Anyhow, the recovery of overheads refers to absorption of overhead. So therefore, friends, these are the different accounting stages, accounting steps involved in accounting of overheads. However, it is very important to note that the distribution of overhead, particularly primary distribution and secondary distribution. Primary distribution of overhead, and thereby we have to prepare a chart or summary which is also known as primary distribution of primary distribution summary. Secondary distribution and the secondary distribution summary. What do you mean by primary distribution? Friends, please do remember, primary distribution is a process of allocation and apportionment of overheads. Meaning to say, specific items of cost are to be allocated to service departments, and common overheads, common costs are to be divided and distributed among all the departments, that is production departments as well as service departments. Therefore, the process of allocation and apportionment of overheads is known as primary distribution, and for this purpose, a chart, a summary, a table is to be prepared, which is known as primary distribution summary. And here, for primary distribution, particularly for apportionment, we have to use several basis, several ratios. Those suitable ratios, suitable basis, can be used to apportion the common overheads. For example, ratio of assets or the capital value. The overhead costs like depreciation, repairs, maintenance charges of that particular asset can be apportioned on the basis of the value of the asset. And take another example, the ratio of space, floor area, the rent of the building, the depreciation of the building, repairs of the building, maintenance charges of the building, etc. can be divided and distributed on the basis of ratio of area. And take another example, the lighting, the electricity charges can be apportioned on the basis of number of light points. And similarly, power charges can be divided and distributed on the basis of kilowatt. And similarly, expenses relating to workers, particularly welfare expenses, canteen expenses, medical expenses, etc., etc., they can be divided and distributed among various departments based on number of workers. So in this way, there are several basis, suitable ratios, which can be used to apportion the common cost, and the process of allocation and apportionment of overheads is known as primary distribution of overheads. Dear friends, after preparing a primary distribution summary, that is after the process of allocation and apportionment, then we have to move towards absorption or reapportionment of overhead. Reapportionment or redistribution of overhead. As I already told you, the costs of service departments are to be divided suitably among various production departments only. Meaning to say, the entire amount of each and every service department will be, the cost of each and every service department will be apportioned, redistributed to various production departments on some suitable basis. And this process is known as secondary distribution. Therefore, secondary distribution is a process of reapportionment of costs of service departments to the production departments on some equitable basis. And there are various bases which we have to follow. And for this purpose, there are different methods we have to use and those methods are generally four types of methods. That is the direct method, that is the direct redistribution method. Here suitable ratio is given. Based on the given ratio, the overhead costs of service departments are to be divided and distributed among various departments. This is a direct method. And there are three more methods: repeated distribution method, step ladder method, algebraic equation method, or linear equation method. Meaning to say, there are four methods: direct method, repeated distribution method, step ladder method, and the last one, linear equation method, which we can discuss in the next video. Anyhow, friends, we have to say that the overheads accounting is gaining much importance nowadays. During earlier days, only prime costs are to be considered. Because of the changing business scenario, changing nature of business practices, and the complexity, etc., etc., overhead accounting is also very important. It helps us for business control, decision making, budgetary control, and preparation of budgets, etc., etc. Therefore, overhead accounting is also important. And we can once again just to recall whatever we have discussed so far. Particularly this topic, the part one, it just concentrated the basic aspects of overheads, its various classification or types of overheads, and how overhead accounting is to be done, what are the stages or what are the steps of overhead accounting, what is the primary distribution, what is the secondary distribution, etc., etc. In my next video, that is part 2 video, particularly we have to concentrate the primary distribution of overhead and secondary distribution of overhead, and in this topic we have to know the preparation of a primary distribution summary, secondary distribution summary, and the various basis, various ratios concerned with primary distributions, and also concerned with the secondary distributions, and particularly the methods which are used for preparing secondary distribution summary. With this much of explanation, I hereby conclude my topic. Dear friends, once again I request you to take very precautionary measure to fight against COVID. Dear friends, it is very easy to celebrate a success, but it is very difficult to manage the crisis. We must learn the art of managing the crisis. Management of crisis is a greatest risk and greatest challenge, and we have to get success over any challenge, particularly to fight against corona. Dear friends, please follow the precautionary measures towards fighting against corona. And I request Almighty to give a better strength to fight against corona. I wish you best of best health and happiness. Thank you. Thank you one and all.